British Prime Minister Boris Johnson has apologized for attending a bring-your-own-booze gathering at his official residence during the first coronavirus lockdown. Johnson admitted for the first time that he had attended the party at Downing Street on May 20, 2020, when social gatherings were limited to a bare minimum, but said he understood the anger that the revelations had caused. Johnson, who won a landslide 2019 election victory on a promise to secure Britain's exit from the European Union, said he regretted his action and had thought the gathering was a work event. His opponents want him to resign.
Mr. Speaker, I want to apologise. I know that millions of people across this country have made extraordinary sacrifices over the last 18 months. I know the anguish that they have been through, unable to mourn their relatives, unable to live their lives as they want, or to do the things they love. And I know the rage they feel with me and with the government I lead when they think that in Downing Street itself, the rules are not being properly followed by the people who make the rules. And though I cannot anticipate the conclusions of the current inquiry, I have learned enough to know that there were things we simply did not get right. And I must take responsibility.
Well, joining us now is an international affairs expert, Mr. Paul Ejime. Mr. Paul Ejime, good evening.
Yes, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you loud and clear. Good evening
happy,
to you.
Happy New Year. Yes.
Happy New Year to you. Now, don't you just love it when the executive branch of government answers to the legislature?
That is what government is about. You know, they have the separation of powers, and then each is supposed to be accountable to the people, the judiciary, the legislature, and then the executive. So what is playing out is democracy in action. So that is what is happening.
So compare this democracy to what we have in Nigeria and Africa as a whole.
Well, it's a world of difference. And you will say that in Africa, we are still, democracy is still in its infancy. Even in America, that you can call the mother of democracy, you can see that they are also still struggling with what happened on the 6th of January last year. But, you know, let's face it, it is not always the case that you find African leaders coming out to apologize for taking any action. So this has to be commended. But within the British context, I think this is also a very costly error, if it was an error, that the Prime Minister has done. And he will probably pay for it. There has been a call for him to resign, but some of his party members are lining, ministers are lining behind him. So we see how it plays. It all boils down to what the 360 Tory, you know, Conservative MPs will do. If 15% of 54 of them manage to raise right to the this powerful 22 committee, they will now trigger a vote of no confidence. And then if that passes, then they can now go into the long process of changing, you know, the leadership of the Tory party. So that is what it is. But here is accountability, that a government cannot be doing, do as I say, but not as I do. So you locked up everywhere for people to stay at home, but you now decided to be having parties at Downing Street, you know, drinking wine and all that. So somebody, an opposition MP called him that says he's a walking dead, because what he has done is, you know, cannot be explained, particularly the fact that they had denied that no such thing happened. Even today, he was still saying that
it was a walk event.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So it's neither here nor there. So how he comes out will depend on the solidity of the support that he has, but he's winning. It is damaging, and it is inconsistency. It's inconsistent with what British ministers and prime ministers are supposed to do.
So
and should happen everywhere. You mentioned Nigeria and Africa. We should learn that when people make mistakes, they are human beings. You have to apologize. Whether this apology will sell, take him through is another thing. But let's see how it goes.
The inquiry is being awaited. How do you see that coming out?
Yes, it is. They will tell you it's democracy in action. An inquiry is also there. But even Labour and the opposition, they are saying that this is a civil servant panel. They will probably come in support of the prime minister. But it's still early days. So between now, 24 hours, they say in politics is a lifetime. So, but the prime minister has really beaten more than he could chew.
Is there a possibility that he could be impeached?
Yes, if he's a survivor, let's say. It could, if it rumbles on to the point where you have this 15% of MPs writing to the committee, of 22, the backbenchers, if they manage to raise that number, then there will be issue the question of triggering no confidence. If that happens, then it will go into, a vote. It's a longer process. But I think he must have learned his lessons. And then this is a lesson for everybody that you do not go, you have to be accountable to the people. You cannot ask ordinary people to stay at home because of COVID, and then you are having parties at your office. I mean, that is contradictory. That is beggars on integrity and then good governance. And so that is what is happening. So accountability. The leaders must be held to account.
Yeah, on a final note, and you have hinted on that, especially when I asked you to compare that to what happened to Nigeria's democracy to what just displayed, what just happened. But on a final note, what lessons for African leaders from this?
The lesson is that nobody is above the law. And whether you are a president or a prime minister, you are still accountable to the people who elected you. But that is not happening in Africa, but it must happen. And the people themselves, these are representatives of the people in parliament now asking this question. But wait, they can go to their constituencies and get further, conviction to come and do and require of the prime minister to account or even resign. Many, about 8 MPs have asked him to resign. Whether that happens, we wait and see. Until the inquiry comes out. But whether the result of the inquiry, whether that will happen or not, is another matter. But this is a lesson for both old democracy, the new democracy, and those who are aspiring to be democratic. They have to learn to, respect the rule. That is what, and democratic principles.
Nigerian lawmakers have been described over time as rubber stamp. What lessons for them?
Okay. Well, what is there is that the three arms of government are supposed to be independent and then operate what they call a separation of powers. But where the one arm becomes very malleable or pliable to the other, the people suffer. Democracy will suffer. So, but that is not to say that it gets to the level of too adversarial, so that it makes governance impossible. But there has to be that level of opposition to keep governments on their toes, to keep prime ministers and presidents on their toes. Nobody is above the law.
Thank you so much, Mr. Ejimeh Paul, for your time.
Thank you for having me.
All right.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.